Hello everyone. In this video, we will look at creating a MySQL database using AWS. So this service will be under RDS. And so let's go and find that. And start by clicking Create Database. We were just going to do the standard create and just select a basic MySQL engine. There's obviously other options, but MySQL is the easiest one to start with here. We're going to use the free tier for this demo and give it a unique identifier. Just like many other things, this has to be unique, but just in this case, just across our individual account. We'll keep the master username as is and just add a password. And keep most of these specs the same. I mean, we're not going to customize this too much. This is really just to get you going. As we get down here to connectivity, one thing to take a look at is, for the sake of our demo, we actually want to make this publicly accessible. Honestly, the only reason we're doing this now is to make it easier on ourselves as we go through this demo course. We'll keep the default security settings, the port, everything else, password. We'll look for our password that we set earlier, and let's create the database. Now this will take a couple minutes, so I'll pause the video and let this do its thing. So this is now available, and we can use this endpoint to connect. So let's copy this, open up really any tool that you want. I use Heidi SQL to connect to MySQL. And I'll give this a new connection name, call it demo AWS. And in the place of the host name, let's paste that endpoint and put in our admin username and password that we set before. Click open. And we are actually going to see an error here. This should block us. There it is. It's saying we can't connect. And the reason is because we need to give our individual IP address permissions to connect to this server. So if we hop back over to our RDS console and go to the default security group, which is what we're using in this case, we need to adjust this to allow our home, my local IP address, and yours in your case, to connect. Let's add an inbound rule for the MySQL connection. You can keep it as custom TCP. The port range is 3306, which is what we set. This is the default one for these database servers. And the source is my IP, and it should pick up whatever yours is. In my case, this is it. And we should save this. And that should be updated now for us. You can see it recognizes this is for a MySQL type of connection. So let's give it another shot. And this time we should be able to connect. And there we go, we're in. We connected to this data server on AWS. We can add new tables, add data, whatever we want, create a whole application off of this. So pretty neat, pretty easy to spin up, and then there's a lot more you can do with this that we'll cover in future videos. I hope you found this helpful, and thanks for watching.